Hey everyone, it is Thursday, October 14th. The time is 5:38 p.m. and the temperature is around 21 degrees Celsius. And this here is the Casa Loma parquet. And there's a look up at the Casa Loma stables. And in a moment, I'll be hopping on the e-bike here and taking it for a spin. And away we go. And they're holding their annual Legends of Horror event here at Casa Loma between the stables and Casa Loma itself, which is just up ahead here. There's a look at it. And I don't really have a plan for this one. Although I do have a place to be in about 40 minutes from now. I was just recording a live stream. It didn't go so well. I ran into some connection issues and I stopped the stream and I started it up again. And I continued to run into problems. So I thought rather than continue on with what very much seemed to be a doom stream, I would pull out the camera and just record a ride from right about where it ended. It was right at this spot here where I ran into problems for the last time. So I do apologize to everyone who was watching that stream. Here is Spadina Road.
Yeah, I thought they should take my company to follow.
So this is a bit of an impromptu, unplanned video. And unfortunately, I don't have the wide-angle lens attachment with me for this camera. Spadina Road continuing to the south of here. And it turns into Spadina Avenue south of Bloor Street. That is Walmer Road. I was thinking about turning left there. It was a one-way street heading in this direction. So now I am riding west. And this is Howland coming up. And what's kind of silly about this is I need to be heading east. This is Howland Avenue. I'm gonna take this opportunity to spin around here. So that's Davenport Road, just a block to the north of here. There's a neat street mural. Oh, this is a really nice old fire station, fire station number 23. So this is the annex neighborhood. You can see some Halloween decorations going up. Might as well just keep going south here down the Bloor. Although it looks like that plan might be foiled, as south of this next street here, it becomes a one-way street. And we are here at Barton Avenue. And I'm now on Brunswick Avenue going south. There's some nice fall colors starting to show. A bike lane for upstream cyclists, so it's a two-way street for cyclists, but one-way for cars. And here's Bloor Street West. This car in front of me is turning right. I'm gonna turn left here. Although I could continue one way down Brunswick. I don't know why I said it like that. And now it's east on Bloor Street West, and I think I'll turn right at Spadina up ahead. So that was a nice little pointless detour through the annex there. Given that all I had to do was just stay going south on Spadina from the onset. I was kind of thinking of taking St. George down, as that would cut through U of T. But given the time of day, I think it would be a bit more interesting if I do that route earlier in the day. So this is south on Spadina Avenue. here is Harvard Street, and to the right is Harvard Village, and to the left, the University of Toronto. Rather noisy moped. That's the Daniels Building straight ahead. It's part of the University of Toronto's Faculty of Architecture. This will take me south through Chinatown here, once I'm south of college. Although I'll avoid turning left at Dundas, as I've been along there a few times recently. Just doesn't seem to be as busy as it used to be. I've noticed a lot of life returning to the city over the past month. Seems to have gotten quite cool. I just refreshed the weather on my phone and it still says it's 21. Here's the main intersection in Chinatown. Oh, that push was a bit on the loud side. That was Dundas and Spadina. Sullivan Street. Oh, this is a definitely going to be a music copyright match waiting to be if I don't keep talking my way through that. I could have done what she did and just gone right through the red light to avoid it, but that's not how you're supposed to do it. And that guy's a total idiot. A all of that just to get to the next red light quicker. How often do you see a couple of these things on the road? And this is Queen Street West. Maybe I'll take King Street over heading east. Such an idiot. And here comes Adelaide Street. I think I'm gonna follow this girl through here. Wow, that Porsche. Just the definition of an idiot. She agreed with me. So now it is going west on Adelaide. Well, I'm gonna make my way down to King. One of the reasons why I was gonna choose King is that I have a plan to do a walk on Adelaide Street East in the not too distant future. And I didn't want to backtrack or find myself kind of backtracking a walk I just did, rather a ride I just did. I'm not thinking about covering that same stretch twice in a short period of time. I was actually thinking of doing that one tomorrow morning. But I do kind of like the skyscraper canyon that we get on Adelaide Street West here. Use this red light as an excuse for turning right and heading down to King. And this is the entertainment district. So now it's east on King Street West. And once I cross University up ahead, or first Simcoe, then University, and I'll be in the financial district. is a transit priority corridor, so vehicles can't go straight through these intersections. Unless you are transit, or an authorized vehicle, or a bicycle. Taxis are exempted from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. So this truck should not be going straight here, I believe. Although there is no straight through sign here. So maybe this intersection is okay. Never noticed that before. And I think the transit only priority corridor runs between Bathurst Street to the west and Jarvis to the east. Here there's just no left turn signs. Engine turn. Coming up is Yonge Street. I could find myself getting stuck behind a parade of streetcars here. They tend to make a lot of frequent stops and you can't pass them while they're doing so. On the King Street East. That's the new home of Google being built on the right there. King and Church. This is the St. Lawrence neighborhood. And here is Jarvis Street. Sign saying that you can't go straight through here, so I think the transit priority corridor actually starts one more block east of here. And this would be Sherburne Street. And here we are at Berkeley Street. The streetcar is about to stop. And we hit a red light anyways. Streetcar will be making a right just up ahead here and heading down to the distillery loop. It will not be going all the way to Broadview Station, which would be the normal destination for some of the 504 Kings, as they're doing a lot of extensive water main repair work on Broadview. There's a police vehicle. Mobile crisis response unit. So I believe these people are getting off the streetcar and awaiting a bus that'll take them the rest of the way. This one still has its lights flashing. Oh, that would be its indicator to turn right. I am really not thinking. I got that confused with the door opening blink for some reason. just up here in the fabulous neighborhood known as Corktown. King Street East comes to an end and it merges into Queen Street East. And this is Lower River Street. So here's where King comes to an end. And if you're wondering what the holdup is, there's a stop sign that every car needs to come to a complete stop before continuing through at. And this will take us over the Don River and the Queen Street Viaducts. And into a mini traffic jam. Looks like the right lane is blocked up ahead, which is causing this bottleneck. It's all caused by one knucklehead with his four ways on, it looks like. Good job, Mr. Dodge Caravan. There's no one even in that vehicle. What a headache they have caused. And coming up is Broadview and Queen. And where I'm heading is just to the north of here. Kind of stuck. I want to turn left. That one cyclist just squeezed through all this traffic here. You know what? I'm gonna U-turn. No one's peeking out around that bus. And we're at the Joel Weeks Park. Oh, the road is closed. I can't do anything right today. Well, this will do. I think. This takes us to Matilda Street. On the other side of the park. And here is Carroll Street. And I think that luxury car dealership would be just here on the left, as this takes us up to Dundas Street East. it's an Aston Martin. That's Monroe Street. There's Hamilton Street. I was thinking I'd like to go north here, but it's a one-way street. Good job, Johnny. All right, let's... continue to get things wrong. I should have just stayed home tonight with the stream issues. All right, I'm gonna double cross. North up Broadview through East Chinatown. I had an idea to end this at the Chinese Archway. I'm gonna be determined to make it happen. So back to Monroe Street. And this will take me up to Girard. More buses. Here's that archway. Take up a parking spot, but just for a second. And there we go, a very unplanned, impromptu ride. That was not at all what I set out to do today. And I hope you enjoyed it nevertheless. There's a look at the Electric Beast. And the archway, whoops, I moved the camera a little fast on that. And me. Whoa. That car almost hit that cyclist there. Anyways, let me know your thoughts and comments down below. If you wish to support the channel, there are links to my Patreon and YouTube channel membership in the description. I'm gonna go have a beer or three right now after all this. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you on the next one.